All right, how's everyone doing? I am Rich Cholenza. Thanks for tuning into the Rich Cholenza Show. WTF are you talking about? So what I want to call today's podcast is don't be a dick. So a lot of times when we hear this saying, I think we automatically think of guys, but this is basically for men and women. And I've seen over the years, I should say over the decades, how people, I think, including myself even sometimes, don't have a lot of respect for others. And I've been traveling so much lately, just in the last month. I don't even know how many cities I've been in. I'm currently in Phoenix, but I went on a cruise, and then I ended up having to go to Boston, New York, back to Florida. Then I ended up having to go to Edmonton, Canada, spend some time in Vancouver, San Jose, and then I'm in Phoenix heading back to Florida tomorrow, and that's just the last couple weeks. So I've been doing a lot of traveling and intense traveling. So even over the years, I've spent a tremendous amount of time on planes, airports, all different restaurants all over North America, even visiting Italy. And I think as time has gone on, I've realized, I think with technology too, is us being able to do things so quickly, we have lost a lot of patience. And not only with, you know, different environments that we're in, but I think with people as well. And I also think a lot of us hide behind our phones to a certain degree. We're not paying attention to our surroundings, because I'll just give you an idea of me, what just happened in, I want to say I'm in San Jose, that it was very busy. It was the San Francisco 49ers playoff was going on. I was there the day before that, actually, and the day of. And it was very busy. So I went to get a rental car. And I realized, you know, I was looking at my phone, because like a lot of people, I'm always looking at my phone. I looked up and I saw a couple ladies standing there. And I stood up, I said, and I had my bag next to me. I didn't even pay attention to that. So I moved my bag and I got up. I said, please, ladies, sit down. And they said, oh, no, please don't worry about it. And I said, are you crazy? Please sit down. We're arguing. Everybody was laughing. I'm not saying this to toot my own horn by any means, because I just caught that. I probably many times don't catch a lot of my, I guess you could say my actions. And again, do I owe them that to sit down before me? No, but I do think it's a sign of respect. It's something that I grew up thinking. That's right. And this isn't a dig. I mean, that's not to say a lot of times, and I'm just going to say this, it's not just about men treating women respectfully, I guess. A lot of women, I don't think, are very respectful as well to men. So it goes both ways. And I realized I got caught not too long ago in, where was I? I was in, was I in Edmonton or Vancouver? I can't remember, but there was some, I want to say it was Vancouver, one of them airports. So when you travel in the winter months, if you do a lot of traveling, you'll know there's a lot of cancellations, a lot of, you know, flights that are being rescheduled, all these type of different things when you're traveling, weather conditions, you know, just, it's just a madhouse. But I went to go check in, and for some reason, they only had two people, and they canceled my flights, two tellers, I guess you could say, checking us all in, and they canceled my flight, so I had to jump into another flight. It was Edmonton going to Vancouver, and I didn't know it at the time. Vancouver, which is very, it usually doesn't happen, but they had like a blizzard there, a lot of snow, so they canceled my flight, which is fine, but then you have to get in another line to reschedule to see if you could catch another flight, because like I was saying earlier, there's delays or cancellations, but I had to get in another line to go do that. So then you're corresponding to say, hey, if I can't catch another flight, I'll fly out of here, whatever. And I'm thinking, wow, do I cancel the entire trip? Because if I can't get in there today, who knows what tomorrow is? Because I heard the all weekend they were supposed to have a lot of snow. So then all of a sudden you're thinking, am I going to be stuck here for a few days? But to make a long story short, you have to go into another line. You can't just go check in. And unbeknownst to me, they booked me on another flight a few hours ago, but I don't know this. I didn't even see it. I didn't get an email. But we're waiting, and it went like an hour, 2 hours. I was literally going on 2.5 hours. And what was interesting is I was about to miss the second flight they booked for me. And I didn't even know this, but they only had two tellers originally and then one. And before you know it, I'm getting super aggravated and I'm really calm for 99% of my life. But if I go into black, I call it, I get nuts. And I'm always looking at, I'm trying to always be self-aware, especially when you travel, because I'm all about making a film and traveling are very similar because all it's about is preventing problems and preventing issues while you're trying to get something accomplished. Because I don't know if you've ever traveled, especially when you're doing one-offs, different cities and states all the time, so much can go wrong compared to what's going right. And you are trying to make maneuvers where everything is consistent. Because if you blow one thing, it's a chain reaction. But to make a long story short, I was getting crazy there. Finally, I'm stepping in line. I'm stepping into the front because there were two tellers originally. Now there's just one. And I had a bunch of Asians in front of me who kept saying, you know, and they couldn't speak English very well. They were going crazy. And then all of a sudden, too, and this had nothing to do with people in wheelchairs, a bunch of people in wheelchairs now all slid to the side of us. So after us literally waiting for almost 3 hours, they were about to address only one. We only had one teller. I even put on Twitter, what the F is going on here, Canada? And I very seldom ever lash out on Twitter. I think it's a phony thing. But I'm like, what is going on in this airport that you only have one teller? And then I first nicely confronted some people that work for Air Canada. They kept saying, we'll take care of it. We're sorry. And then my girlfriend called, scheduled, told me the situation. She's on top of shit with traveling and said, Rich, just go and check in through another area, like you're checking into the airport, just go to the kiosk or whatever the hell they call those things, the machines, and it'll shoot you through, I think, which it did, thank God. But when I first was going up to these people saying, hey, what's going on? You only have one teller, I kept saying. And you're like, oh yeah, we're sorry, sir, we're going to get someone. I'm like, we've been here, first it was an hour and a half, 2 hours, 2.5 hours in line. And behind me was literally another 50 people. Now I'm getting really hot because they all disappeared. So now they only had two people checking regular flights in and one for all of this. And I have sometimes some issues with Canada. I just don't think a lot of their airports are set up correctly. They don't have enough employees a lot of times anytime I travel in and out of there, especially when there's mistakes. And there's always mistakes there because they always have bad weather, especially in December, January, February, even March sometimes. So it's like a catastrophe is going to happen no matter where you're going in Canada. Bad weather, snow. Not only that, they're flying in and out of other bad areas in the States. It could be the East Coast, the Midwest. So you have all this shit going on. But then I started to get really crazy. I started walking up to the tellers. I was screaming at management. Finally, I did what I said earlier, and I was able to check in and go. And then I was giving my luggage, and the guy who was worked there was upset because he was supposed to take a break a long time ago. And she even said, you have to leave. I guess it's a law. You have to leave. He's like, well, then who's going to grab people's luggage? She literally said, I don't know. So he did my luggage, thank God. I caught my flight, and he left with me. And again, I sometimes look at my behavior. Was it good or bad? A lot of people there were really excited that I was getting nuts, and they were getting behind me. And I'm not saying this was a dick mentality, but sometimes, you know, sometimes I overreact, I think, and I think a lot of us, my point being, is overreacting. And a lot of times, did overreacting actually help me? No, it didn't. Because sometimes you got to realize you are in a position where you can't win sometimes in life. It's just a reality. I am not going to be able to control the planes, the weather. I can't control Air Canada. I definitely cannot control Edmonton Airport. And you get nuts sometimes, and before you know it, you know, your stress level is going higher and higher and higher. And I know tons of people that traveled for years that had to quit because of the stress. And like I said, I normally can handle anything regarding travel because I'm always, like I said, prepared for the unexpected. But back to being a dick, I realized, too, a lot of people, if they don't get their way regarding many different things. So that was an extreme case. But I watch people when I travel, and it could be when they're getting on a plane, they're acting like an asshole. I had a woman right in front of me screaming that she needed a better seat. The lady said, you didn't pay for a better seat. The lady said she wanted an aisle. She didn't pay for an aisle. There was no availability. Then she's screaming she needed to be up front. Again, she didn't pay for that. Like, it was just crazy how she was behaving towards this person that works at the airport. And that's just one case. I am at a rental car, and this just happened again where I went to I think it was actually San Jose. I got there and I noticed this long line at Dollar, like 50 people deep. And I'm an express member. I don't have to wait. People were going crazy and I get it. I went right to the, you could, if you're an express member, you get to go right to the garage. And I went there. I said, hey, I'm an express member. I had to get out of there because I had to go do some work that night. And he's like, what's your name? I gave him my name. He goes, oh, okay, well, our systems are down. So I said, okay. I said, that's cool. How long they've been down? So he was ignoring me. Now, I wanted to blast them. And then there were a couple other express members there, an Asian lady especially, that says, I've been waiting here forever. They're not fixing their systems. In 1 minute, I dipped. I went down. I went to Enterprise. And I just went up to Enterprise. And there was a line there as well. And I said, hey, do you have any cars available? One of the ladies screamed, yes. I said, great. So I got in a long, not a long line, but a decent line. And I went up there and I said, hey, I want to get a car for the day. It's only 1 day. With Enterprise, I'm an A-list as well there because I use both of those pretty often, especially when I'm back in Florida. And the other teller tells me, no, we don't have any availabilities in cars. I said, well, the other lady just told me you do. And she's like, we don't. I says, can you ask that lady? So she asked that lady. And the lady goes, yeah, we have a bunch of availability. Why are you telling him we don't? Plus, he's like an A-list, whatever. She's like, I don't see it here on the computer. So them two are arguing. And then she's like, I'm sorry, sir. She was cutting me off. The other girl had to come and confront her and say, and then show her. And then she kept apologizing and says, oh, I'm sorry. We do have cars. I was, you know, minutes away from blowing up because now, you know, Dollar isn't working for me. Their system's down. I don't know how long that's going to be. Enterprise has kind of bullshit me after I waited in that line. And again, I was just trying to keep calm and things did work themselves out. But again, I'm seeing people next to me that were shifted from Dollar also to Enterprise screaming in line, having issues with even Enterprise because, you know, they're not A-list or whatever. And then the price difference and, you know, the availability of certain cars that they booked maybe with Dollar that they don't have. And they were, you know, they only had like luxury cars or whatever the case may be. And again, not to get long-winded on this stuff, but I think a lot of us have to recognize or realize that we're acting, and I get when it's not, sometimes we just get pissed and we're going to get pissed. And I'm using traveling just as an example, but this goes for people at home as well. I see it in grocery stores. I see it at Starbucks. I think I'm seeing it more and more and more where the non-respect that we're giving each other. Sometimes it could be wonderful. I see people helping each other, but as I step back, I look, a lot of times we don't open a door for one another. That's guys and girls. I'm not even saying women. We're kind of cutting people in line, and I see this on the airplane all the time. Like we land and guys and girls jump up and they run to the front. I see people, you know, shoving each other in the airports and bumping into others. I see people cutting each other off. I see people when you're going to a restaurant, like, you know, they're waiting in line and they jump in front of everybody to get their name, put first so that they could sit quicker. I see in the bar the other day again, when I was on Santana Row, and I'm not the smallest guy. I'm not going to say I'm the biggest guy, but I do. I guess I have a disposition where I look like I'm not going to fuck around. You know what I mean? And I just went into a Chinese restaurant. It was slammed and there was no seating. And then the bar opened up, but there was enough room for me because I'm kind of wide. I guess you could say I'm definitely not a guy who's going to be at a bar that takes up just one stool. It's usually like a stool and a half size wise. And then I set my phone up and I watch, pardon the interruption, or whatever, I'm watching YouTube of some sort. And a smaller Asian lady sat next to me, and a bigger, kind of a boyfriend, her boyfriend or somebody came and kind of like, he wanted to stand at the bar, and truthfully, there was no room for him. So then he kind of shoved his way in the man. At first I moved over a little, then he kept like shoving me. And I was getting extremely aggravated. And I said, let me go take a piss actually and come back and see how this works out. So now instead of him like kind of just like shoving me a little, he's got his whole body, his back to me. I sat down and then I had to just literally open up and like literally just move him. And I think he turned around and looked, and I guess I didn't have, you know, I did not have the face like I was like, I'm like ready to get nuts if he wanted to. He seemed like a nice guy. And then he just understood, and then he wrapped around, and then he was just out of my way. And again, he knew I was there. He was kind of trying to test me. And that's another thing I want to say is, if you're out there testing people, you know, and thinking you're going to get away with certain shit, you, and I talk about this before, you are going to run across the wrong person at the wrong time, on the wrong day. And I'm not saying I'm that person. I may be that person, and I also may run across the wrong person on the wrong day. I hope I worded that correctly. Sometimes I screw things up. It's not easy to like run through these things because I don't take notes, but you know, just be very aware of your actions, especially I think with a lot of younger people too. I think sometimes they're not as self-aware as, say, older middle-aged guys, because I think we grew up at a time, not better or worse necessarily, where we were always being programmed to, you know, we weren't programmed on our phones, I guess you could say. So even though we're attached to our phones, middle-aged guys, I still think we have an awareness, and I realize that more when I go to gyms, because I always see middle-aged guys where they're always opening the door, very, very nice. They're very, I can't say compassionate, and they're very aware of sharing and being very sympathetic or just understanding, where I see younger people, they're much more aggressive. And that doesn't mean they're bad by any means. Young people are, you know, they're used to, and I don't blame them, they're used to results quickly. And they're used to getting their way sometimes, I think. And I can see that with my own kids sometimes. They don't have a lot of patience, and they were just raised differently. And I get it's a day and age where it's a lot, there's a lot more people, I think, too. People got to realize if you're middle-aged than what we, I think I grew up in. And I grew up in Chicago, which was a very busy city. But as you know, the population is growing unbelievably. And you know, I live in Orlando, Florida with my daughters, my girlfriend, their kids, and you go to places like Disney Springs, or you could go to Universal Studios, or you go anywhere in Florida for the most part now, and it's just getting busier and busier and busier. Now, when I lived in California, it was always busy. I'm always in New York, very busy in a lot of major cities, and you just have to fight your way through it to survive. But there also, I believe, is a way to do it right and a way to do it wrong. And I really, like, no matter who serves me, I'm always thanking them every time they do anything for me. Or I don't see a lot of people thank people anymore. They don't have a lot of gratitude, respect for even the homeless, which I understand sometimes the homeless get nuts and they act out. Or just other people are acting out in general. You just got to step back and try not to let them ruin your mood or ruin your day. Now, I just gave you a couple examples of me getting nuts just because it was kind of a crazy time, but very seldom do I actually get very upset. But at the same time, I do understand sometimes that when I'm wanting to get things accomplished personally, and I think I did this when I was trying to make films, I became very self-centered. And I didn't even realize how self-centered I was. I thought I was always helping people. But the reality was I was more interested in having others help me. And of course, I would help them. And I learned a very valuable lesson once, because I worked with somebody who was really always helping me. And then I created a clothing line, and he wanted to be a part of it, and he was a part of it. And then we had some, you know, I had a name, and I'm not going to get into the whole thing. And then he went and did something. But I remember when I had a discussion with him, all the years he helped me. And I was really, you know, I really appreciated all the help he did. But he reached out to me a couple times, and I was just too busy to a certain point to do what he needed done. And it was, you know, after all the time and effort he put in for me, I just wasn't, I didn't have the time. And I think he took offense to that. And I understand that. I should have really took more time out to do that. So when he reacted, then I reacted even worse. And before you know it, you're in a war. And he didn't deserve that. I'm not saying I necessarily deserve that. But sometimes if you look back at yourself, you got to really address it. Say, you know what? I made a mistake here. I either overreacted. I am self-centered. I'm selfish. I'm not really paying attention to my surroundings. And I think this happens with a lot of friends, family members, and colleagues sometimes. That at times we become, especially if you're kind of an entrepreneur or you're somebody that is always developing things or wants to create things, you don't realize all the people that are always helping you. And I'm not saying, I don't know what you do or who you are, but a lot of times we are helping others. There's no question about that. But sometimes we start acting like a dick when we don't get our way. And that could be definitely at the workplace. We start lashing out. Or family members, we just get exhausted. We may be just burning out. And I just thought I would do a podcast regarding this subject because, again, it's not for just men, it's women, where I think we, a lot of times, we're just not respectful towards one another when we should be just a little more. That doesn't mean you have to kiss everyone's ass, but I definitely think saying thank you, I appreciate you, great job, a hug, a kiss goodbye, all those type of things are really, really mean a lot to people, especially people. And I see, a lot of times you see people with fast food, back to Starbucks or in those environments, working really hard, and people just almost treat them as they're disposable or they're not even human. And if they don't get their coffee their way, they immediately come back and start like lashing out. Or if they don't get their meal perfect, or and I get sometimes there's good service and bad service, 100%. We all get that. But sometimes I definitely think we overreact and we need to just chill out a little bit. You know what I mean? There's more to life than just getting a perfect cup of coffee or having, a perfect dinner that's, it's not always going to be as consistent as you want. Or just anything in life. It's just not always going to be perfect. But that's no reason to ruin the day or have it ruin your day or just get in a situation where it could lead and escalate to something very bad. Because I talk about that all the time. One bad moment, one bad day, one bad event can change your life forever. And it's definitely not always for the best, it's for the worst. So just be very aware of that. So that's all I'm going to really say about that. If you get a chance, you might want to check out my YouTube channel. I've been doing a lot of different videos on different cities I've been going to, especially Little Italy's. I just posted one tonight, Vancouver, Little Italy, off Commercial Drive, which it's not just Little Italy there. It's not just Italians there. They got a multicultural different restaurants, people there. And yeah, I did Edmonton's Little Italy, just some small ones. And then I did a really well-known cool taco place in Manhattan in Times Square. I did some fitness videos. So yeah, if you like, check that out. I'm also on LinkedIn, Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. And I want to thank everybody that listens to my podcast because I've been traveling a lot and I have a lot of family members and friends that say they listen, which I'm very grateful for. And if you agree with me or not agree with me, disagree with me, I understand completely. And I'm always willing to listen and learn because I don't, a lot of times when I speak, I definitely think as I look back, I evolve and I change. And it's not that I'm a flip-flopper, but sometimes what I believe at one time in my life, I definitely change as time goes on because I just learn more and I take on a different disposition. And back to being a dick, I think back to people's political or religious views, a lot of times, especially on social media, I think we have gone too far lashing out and really like just saying. And I get sometimes we want to state our opinions, but there's a right way, I think, sometimes, and a wrong way to go about it. And I even see on my YouTube or comments I get on Facebook or wherever where there's a dig, It's to make you feel like a piece of shit, but don't let anybody make you feel like a piece of shit. I'm going to tell you right now, who gives a fuck? Really, if and I get a lot of times words do hurt, but the reality is, who even knows who these people are sometimes that you don't know? You don't even know if they're real people. You don't know what they're doing. You don't know if it's a scam. But if they have nothing, a lot of times too, though I will say, I've had comments, I'll just use this to wrap it up on YouTube. And I've screwed up certain things. I'm in so many different places. I don't know the culture like as if I live there. And sometimes I'll say something incorrectly or I'll write something incorrectly because that's what I was told or what I thought. And somebody, they'll attack you. And then I'll actually say, I appreciate you giving me this information. And then I'll write in there, I made a mistake. I'll re, you know, whatever the case. Sometimes I may even delete a video if I think it's really wrong. But, you know, I don't take that stuff personal. And even though a lot of people may treat you like a dick, sometimes you just don't take it that personal. I know at the time, a lot of times we want to take it personal, and there's a different level of, you know, not getting the respect you want. But sometimes you just got to say, you're not worth it. And I know that's hard at the moment, but really, what is worth it at the end of the day? I try to teach my kids, I have to talk to my mother and everybody. Is the argument worth it? Is the battle worth it? And a lot of times it's not. So if you sometimes take a different approach, which is a calmer, smarter approach, and I talked about this in my books before, giving it a 48-hour turnaround. If you do start to have issues with somebody, or you're about to blow up or whatever, especially if it's through an email, a text, or whatever, give yourself 24 to 48 hours to calm down. Or even if you want to write up the email, don't send it, or write it in your notes or text, but don't send it. And usually if you wait 24 to 48 hours, you go back. A lot of things may happen in between there, but also you are kind of caught up in the moment and you don't realize that, you know what, that may not be really how you feel. And you just had more time to think it through. And patience, I'm telling you, it's a game changer. But if you lash out immediately or react, if you're allowing people to constantly get under your skin and you have to keep reacting the way they're reacting, they're kind of taking you out of your game. And if that's not you, don't let it, you know what I mean? Don't let them bring out something inside of you that's really not you. That's just my theory. All right, I'm going to wrap it up there. If you're traveling, safe travels and take care.